Hey guys, I want to share with you my little St. Patrick's Day recipe reveal. It's gonna be fun for kids in the kitchen. Super simple. Get your pen and paper, and I hope you enjoy this. And it's a crock pot recipe, and I got this at Vaughn's. Corned beef brisket comes in a bag. It was like on sale for $8. Number one. And I also got some little carrots. These happen to be rainbow carrots, kind of pretty. Carrots. And green cabbage. Yams, or is this a sweet potato? I think it's a sweet potato. And of course, get as many as you need depending on the size of your family. And so those are the items I threw in the crock pot. Don't forget the green St. Patrick's Day beer. And what I did, I put two or three drops of green food coloring. So you might as well put that down with your pen and paper. Green food coloring. And put the drops in first, then pour your beer. And the foam was a real pretty light green, but obviously the foam is gone now. So there's non-alcoholic beer or duels. You'll know what's right for your family. Non-alcoholic family can also take the apple cider, Martinelli's apple cider, don't forget, and put a little green food coloring. Oh my goodness. I love beer. Okay, so we might as well put this down on our list. Mustard. Whatever your family likes. There's the old-fashioned yellow mustard, Grey Poupon, whatever your mustard thing is. And I just set that on the table. And you can try to add a dash of green food coloring. It depends on your family. If you have fun little kids that love to get gooey, fun color in their food, it's fun to try to make the mustard green, but you have to try that out before. It's probably not something adults would gravitate toward, but again, it's just fun to surprise your kids. You know, like the green eggs and ham. This would be green mustard and corned beef or something. I don't know. So you have to think about how far you go with the green food coloring. And, for the drinks, you know, 7-Up comes. You can find 7-Up or Mountain Dew in a green container. But to make it fun, I put a drop of green food coloring in. So when your kids sit down, say, would you like some 7-Up? So they're just going to think it's going to come out like 7-Up, but it's going to come out green. That's a fun surprise. And I'm not sure if there's a green Gatorade. We didn't have one, so I just put water in here with green food coloring. So it's just colored water. And you can make have pitchers of water on the table that everybody knows is water with one little light drop of green food coloring. That's a new idea. And you see here, you see all the green? I just had this stuff around the house. Here's like a green placemat. Excuse me. And then here's these green bandanas. I have like this green, then this green, and then way over here is like a dark green. I don't know if you can see that. So whatever you have, those can be like little napkins on their lap or napkins on the table. Just keep your eyes open. What do you have in the house? Look, I have these little green forks and spoons. And of course, we know my green little feather. I don't know, maybe I could put that like on a centerpiece with some flowers. I don't know. But you know, just think of who might enjoy your arts and crafts that you have. And lucky we just have green. On the counter, you know, in a pump bottle. But I wonder if you can add like a green to your soap so it comes out green, or green to your hand sanitizer. I don't know. You have to think about that. These are just things that came to mind as I was thinking on my St. Patty's Day meal and how fun it is when you have little kids that you could surprise and have fun with. You know, think of them waking up on St. Patty's Day and they go to the restroom in your bathroom in the house and they go to wash their hands and there's green soap come out of the bottle. Okay, so a while back I had some chard. The chard leaves are huge. You know, I like to decorate the plate. And this was rainbow chard, which each stalk was a different color. Usually chard has a red and green leaf, red stalk. This has a light green, this has orange, this has red, and I think the other ones I used were like yellow, but it's a rainbow chard. Cool. So, and then, this is so simple. Put like a little teeny tiny bit of water, like half inch max water on the bottom of your crock pot. Put this meat in, and they said put it in fat side up. Yes, they don't give you the directions for a crock pot. I just used the kind of the same idea as for an oven. And then they give you like this little seasoned packet. So when the was in the crock pot with this side up, I sprinkled the seasoned packet on top. And it looks like it might not be done. It's like a bright reddish color, but believe me, it's done. I guess brisket just stays that color. So I put that in, sprinkled the seasoned packet on top with the fat side up. Then this is kind of like the vegetable. There's some juice. And if you kind of want to have like a huge, you know, meat and potatoes kind of meal, you would. And again, these leaves are optional. I just always like to decorate. So there's your piece of meat. Another fun side is just a sandwich. You guys know I love sandwiches. Oh, but first let me tell you about this bread. Write this down. It's called Irish soda bread. I got it at Vaughn's. It was on sale, $4. It comes like in a round loaf with big speckles of sugar on top. And raisins. It's more like a raisin bread, comparable to like our raisin bread. So it might be something you'll have for breakfast. Here it is. See? It almost looks like little bits of chocolate, but it's like a raisin. It's delicious. For like breakfast or dessert bread. Okay. But my favorite, here we are. Now this is Jewish rye bread. And you can buy it anywhere, I think. I think they have a ton of different rye breads. This just happens to be Jewish. So whatever it is that your family likes, and remember, I know most of us know kind of these recipes. I always think of kids. I always have kids in mind when I do my recipes. So. And this brisket is really salty, so right up my alley. And so I'm just gonna take like a piece of this, put it on there like that, and first, I'm having the best time. Happy St. Patrick's Day. Thanks for watching.